Hi, I'm Charles with AniCap. The story begins as a YouTuber named Paco starts up a live stream. He's celebrating his channel reaching 700,000 subscribers, and he's joined by his new classmate and beauty tip YouTuber named Rumi. They have a model to demonstrate Rumi's makeup techniques, and this turns out to be our protagonist named Haben. Haben hates these YouTubers and wishes they would at least give him a share of the revenue for humiliating him like this. Paco gets annoyed with Haben and reminds him that he's supposed to smile to his viewers. Paco then reveals that he will be giving away a brand new PC to one of his lucky subscribers, but Haben knows that it's just a scam. Paco says goodbye as the stream is about to end, and Haben forces himself to smile. Haben has a hard time cleaning off all the makeup and admits to hating school these days. Paco is a troublemaker and YouTuber with 700,000 subscribers. His grades are awful, but he knows how to rake in the cash. Rumi is a newbie YouTuber, but she's able to live off her looks. Haben gets frustrated when comparing himself to them because he is neither rich nor smart. He returns to class to find that a kid named Snapper is furious with him for not smiling during the stream. Snapper stomps all over Haben as he messed up the live broadcast. Snapper is Paco's cameraman, and he definitely falls into the delinquent group at school. Haben almost stands up for himself, but this just makes the others mock him. Paco thinks he's just getting carried away, and Snapper pretends that he almost wet himself from fear. Haben thinks about how Snapper volunteered to be Paco's cameraman so he could piggyback on his authority. It's a pretty spineless move, but Haben concedes that Snapper is a good strategist. Snapper wonders if Haben wants more, but Haben just concedes that this is the school's pecking order and he is at the bottom. Just then, Rumi is amazed to learn that she was able to make $200 from the stream they just did. Haben is shocked to hear this since they barely did anything, but still managed to make $200 during lunch break. It's all thanks to Paco, so Rumi promises to repay him somehow. Haben considers starting his own YouTube channel, and he's surprised when Snapper says the exact same thing. Snapper asks Paco for some advice, so Paco explains that minors can't receive revenue, so he will need his parents' bank account. Snapper got caught taking his parents' money before, so there is no chance that they will let him use their account. Snapper knows that Haben's mom is sick and in the hospital, so he has to use his mom's account. Everyone laughs at how rude Snapper is being, and Haben thinks about how this is the moment where he should use his fists. Unfortunately, he can't bring himself to do it, so he just apologizes to his mother for not sticking up for her. Haben goes to visit her, and she tries to stay positive by pretending like she could go home whenever she wants. Haben knows that she is lying though, since her condition will definitely get worse if she leaves the hospital. She wonders if Haben got in a fight because of all the marks on his face, but Haben declares that he would never do something like that. He would never worry his mother by telling her how things are at school, so Haben thinks about how he is a liar too. Haben goes to pay the $200 for his mother's medical treatment, and thinks about how that's an entire week's worth of pay from his part-time job. Haben works at McDonald's, and even if he worked every day after school, he would still only make like $30 a day. Meanwhile, his YouTube classmates are able to make $200 in just one lunch break. Haben becomes furious and wonders what is wrong with society. Just as he falls into despair, Haben realizes that there is still hope in his life when his coworker named Bami greets him. Haben tells her where the beef patties are, and the other simps offer to get them for her. Bami is the idol of their restaurant, and just looking at her makes Haben happy. Just then, Paco arrives at the restaurant while live streaming. Haben hides, and Paco reveals that he is there to see the goddess of McDonald's, who has been blowing up on social media. Haben is shocked that he came to see Bami, and Paco reveals that he has a challenge for her. If she isn't able to make a hamburger in 30 seconds, then she will have to give him her number. This is Haben's worst nightmare, as he knows exactly what Paco is doing. That specific burger has over 10 ingredients, and it would be impossible to make in under 30 seconds. It's pretty clear that he's just trying to get her phone number. Paco acts like he didn't want to do the challenge, but his viewers forced him to. The other workers point out that none of them even have Bami's contact info, and they wonder if YouTubers are allowed to do whatever they want. Tensions rise, but everyone is shocked when Haben reveals that he finished making the burger. He even added an extra patty on the house, so he asks Paco to leave as he is disturbing their customers. The situation is now handled as Haben whispers to himself that he is the king of McDonald's, and the other guys commend him on a job well done. Haben knows that it's not all good though, as he will surely get beat up at school for this. He doesn't think anyone would ever accept him for who he is anyway, but we see that he managed to get Bami's attention. At home, Haben makes some ramen, and we see just how spineless he really is, as he has allowed Snapper to start streaming from his house. Haben is really disappointed in himself, and he apologizes to his mom for letting Snapper use her bank account. Haben overhears that someone's going to give Snapper $200 for getting 30 kills, and he curses him for already making such easy money. He is so annoyed that he spits in Snapper's ramen. Snapper forced him to make it, so Haben wonders if he should ask Snapper to share some of the revenue he is getting. Just then, Haben trips over an extension cord, disconnecting Snapper's stream and covering him in burning hot ramen. Haben apologizes for the accident, but Snapper is furious that he's losing out on $200. Haben again says that it was just an accident, but Snapper just throws insults at him. As Haben gets kicked relentlessly, he begins to realize just how pathetic it is to be getting beat up in his own house. The beatdown continues, but Haben becomes enraged when Snapper tells him that it's his fault his mom has cancer. Haben retaliates with a swift punch to Snapper's face. For the first time ever, Haben punched someone. The two begin fighting, and Haben realizes that fighting isn't as big of a deal as he had always thought. The guys fight without holding back, but they don't realize that the camera to the live stream is still on. Elsewhere, some girl from their school watches the stream. After the fight, Haben's adrenaline settles, and he begins to feel the pain. That isn't the only bad thing, as he realizes that it will cost money to fix the house. Haben hates that he always has to worry about money, and decides to just escape all his problems by sleeping. It was in this moment that Haben realized just how miserable he is. He still thinks about the electricity bill he will have to pay, so he turns off a nearby power strip. The next morning, Snapper calls him, and furiously demands that he take down a video. Haben has no clue what he's talking about, so Snapper explains that he needs to delete the YouTube livestream from the day before. Haben points out that the stream disconnected when he tripped over the cable, but he realizes that the cord he unplugged was just for the monitor, not the computer. Snapper breaks down in tears as he reveals that their entire fight was broadcast in full from the camera. The monitor went black, but it was all streamed live. That isn't all though, as the stream was made into a video as well. Haben denies ever uploading it, but Snapper explains that YouTube does it automatically if a PC goes offline during a live stream. Snapper isn't able to delete it himself since it's on Haben's mom's account. Snapper wants the password, but the panicked Haben just ignores him to check if it's all true. Haben is horrified to find that it's all true, and the video already has over 10,000 comments. It has even reached other social media sites, and it's clear that the video spread all over the world overnight. Haben thinks it's terrible, since he is going from just being bullied locally to being bullied globally. He prepares to delete the video before things get worse, but he reads some comments about how much money it will make because it has so many views. YouTube pays a little over half a penny for every view, so Haben does the calculations and is stunned to realize that this 10 million view video will make a little over $6,000. At school, the students laugh while watching the ridiculous fight. Snapper arrives and can instantly tell that they have seen it. He is furious since he worked so hard to suck up to Patco in order to get popular. That's all ruined because the fighting video has made him the laughingstock of the school. Snapper refuses to go down like this, so he picks an easy target to bully. Snapper confidently prepares to assert himself and reestablish the pecking order at school. He does this by smacking his easy target, but there's no coming back for him as this backfires and the target begins beating him up. Snapper begs for Patco to help him, but Patco couldn't care less. Snapper has been shoving people down his entire life, so it's pretty clear to him that he won't be able to change his new reputation as the laughingstock. At the hospital, Haben is shocked by an $800 medical bill. Haben was just joking though, and confidently pays it off. It's no big deal to him now, as he knows that he has over $6,000 coming in soon for the video. Just then, Snapper appears to punch him right in the face. He points out that he is the school laughingstock and demands half the money from the video. Haben refuses, so the two begin to fight again. Haben has already fought him once, so he is no longer scared. Afterwards, Haben tries to make Snapper feel better, but still refuses to give him any of the money. Just then, Snapper reveals that he recorded the fight they just had. He planned the whole thing and showed his awesome camera angle skills while hiding the camera. Haben fears that he's going to upload it himself, but Snapper points out that nobody would watch the same recycled content. they would just claim that it was staged and insult them for making the video. Snapper didn't actually come to fight Hobbin, he came to ask Hobbin to join him. Snapper offers to make him even more money, and Hobbin is amazed at the thought of being able to make the same kind of money again. Snapper points out that he is Petco's former producer, so he could do the same for Hobbin. Snapper knows that Hobbin hasn't received the money from the video yet, and explains that he will have to do a lot of complex stuff to get monetized on YouTube, including a screening. That isn't all though, as Snapper overwhelms Hobbin with questions about who will film and edit his videos. Snapper points out that Petco was only able to make it big because of his planning and camera work. Snapper offers to be his producer and explains that all Hobbin will have to do is show up. He tells Hobbin to just trust him so they can make money together, and Hobbin imagines how much money he can make. Snapper is a seriously evil strategist, as he can tell that he has Hobbin right where he wants him. His real plan is to just use Hobbin in his account so he can once again climb up the pecking order. Hobbin wants to know how they will split the money, so Snapper explains that he will manage everything. They are friends now, so he decides that he will get 90% of the revenue and Hobbin will get 10%. The two prepare to shake on it, and the evil Snapper thinks about how Hobbin will do all the hard work and he will simply rise with ease. However, it turns out that Hobbin isn't that dumb. He rejects the offer and reminds Snapper that they are not friends. Snapper realizes that his idea is nothing without Hobbin, so he tries to offer a 50-50 split. Hobbin declines again, stating that he would be better off flipping burgers. Snapper panics as Hobbin is completely disinterested, so he offers to just take 10% while Hobbin keeps the rest. Our genius negotiator of a protagonist finally agrees and eagerly awaits to hear Snapper's idea for new content. Snapper is furious that Hobbin isn't as dumb as he thought, but he's glad that they made the deal. He then surprisingly reveals that their new content will be calling out bullies in real time. Thanks for watching my recap. Sign up to my free newsletter if you want to show some support to the channel. Link is in the description.